make this money. And welcome back, guys, and this is Mike Rato, and welcome to a new episode of our What If series. So we're going to make a What If series where The Undertaker actually drafted on Monday Night Raw in 2004. What will be the effects on Raw 2004? What will be the effects on the Reign of Terror, especially Triple H has one more year to have his Reign of Terror, and what will happen to the last? So just like in real life, The Undertaker actually beats Kane, and in the next night on Monday Night Raw, Kane appears completely scared, shocked, especially he has his mixed emotions because The Undertaker, who he buried alive, just defeated him in WrestleMania 20. We are not dropping that storyline yet, and we're not making Kane to be involved in Matt Hardy versus Lita. So yeah, Kane actually had his doubts during that episode. What happened at WrestleMania 20? Why he got beaten easily? He calls out The Undertaker, and then The Undertaker just comes to the ring and beats up Kane yet again, continuing their said rivalry. Because remember, The Undertaker is angry at this time for Kane burying him and actually rebirth of the Phenom, which it's the death of the American Badass in 2003. And also, Paul Bearer actually makes promos during the next week of Raw, telling Kane about this and that. You know how Kane and Paul Bearer can make promos, and The Undertaker also. So the three have their promos with each other, The Undertaker with Paul Bearer versus Kane. So yeah, at the next pay-per-view, The Undertaker again beats Kane. And then what happens is that in the pay-per-view rematch between Shawn Michaels, Chris Benoit, and Triple H, Benoit defeated them just like in real life, and then Benoit will actually continue the storyline in Triple H and HBK, having a lot of matches between the three of them, either 1v1 or triple threat, whichever the case may be. So after a lot of rematches between HBK and Triple H for the World Heavyweight Championship, The Undertaker will involve himself in that said match for the world title. He will make his intentions clear, and in this time, the match happens between The Undertaker, Chris Benoit, Triple H, and HBK. In the first match, they will put Benoit over, as he is now the biggest babyface on Monday Night Raw, except The Undertaker and Shawn Michaels. And then The Undertaker will have is another rematch, wherein this time, The Undertaker will win the World Heavyweight Championship. Sorry, Randy Orton, but your run with the World Heavyweight Championship this time is only to have WWE have their bitterness on Brock Lesnar. So The Undertaker wins the title, and he will have a huge one with it, as Kane is also the mid-card, dominating the mid-card scene with his Intercontinental Championship. And during this time, Triple H and Evolution will kidnap Paul Bearer in storyline. They will make him suffer because the man who has the world title, Triple H's title, is The Undertaker, and they want The Undertaker to show his emotions for Paul Bearer, which Kane will also kind of involve himself, trying to have also a small tweener turn during this time, but he is not completely a babyface because that is his father. While The Undertaker and Kane will try to fight Evolution, and yes, Randy Orton is a mid-card champion in real life at this time. He will fight Kane in a lot of matches, in which in this timeline, Kane will just defeat Randy Orton easily, and when Paul Bearer comes, Kane will try to aid The Undertaker and have a mini Brothers of Destruction reunion during 2004. So why did I make them reunite in this time. Because of the common foe, and common goal. And that is their common friend, that is Pallbearer, Kane's father, and the Undertaker's manager. As for common enemies, well, it is Evolution. And as for common goal, is to destroy Evolution, which Kane and the Undertaker will have a lot of promos versus Evolution having this haunty type of stick where they have as the Brothers of Destruction. And Kane will be a tweener this time, even though fans are cheering him because of his involvement with the Undertaker. He is not a fully face, as I explained to you. Well, during that time also, when Pallbearer actually got into cement, we will put that storyline here instead of having Paul Heyman having the Pallbearer in the cement. Well, Evolution will screw The Undertaker and Kane in a tag team match on a pay-per-view, which actually causes Pallbearer to be buried alive in a cement. And as the rivalry goes by, the two brothers actually got their separate ways because their common goal, their common foe actually got the upper hand, and their common friend, their common ally, Pallbearer, just got buried. And then after that said rivalry, the two brothers will part ways, and then Kane will just revert to his heel mode. I told you he is not a babyface yet at that time, which he will be in 2005 when they will reunite again for a rivalry which The Undertaker and Kane will be involved to. And as for The Undertaker, he will be a champion until 2005, where New Year's Revolution will come. And then, just like in real life, Triple H will win the Elimination Chamber match by last eliminating The Undertaker in this instance, because The Undertaker just destroyed Batista in this match. And then Evolution will attack The Undertaker in this match. And as for Kane, when he won his match for the Intercontinental Championship, he was assaulted by Evolution in backstage, so that they have a guarantee for their plan to destroy The Undertaker and reclaim Triple H title. And yeah, just like in real life also, Batista wins the Royal Rumble and will start his face turn. So what happens to Randy Orton's face turn? Well, he will not turn face because he is just this cocky Orton, which he will kind of be removed in television as of this time, and he will return before WrestleMania during the New Year's Revolution, which is January, and I think WrestleMania is on March, which he will be off screen because Undertaker will just assault Randy Orton just to remove a threat. And then when he comes back, he will debut this theme song, Burning My Light. And then as for The Undertaker, well, he will go to WrestleMania with another heel or another babyface that he can feud with. And as for the World Heavyweight Championship, well, Evolution will start to have fight between themselves with Batista and Triple H, and also Ric Flair will kind of involve himself in that match, and even teasing a face turn. And as for Randy Orton, he will return and he will interject himself in that match. So we will have the Evolution dream match here in WrestleMania 21 between Randy Orton, Triple H, Ric Flair, and Batista, in which Batista will win that said match, and then he will be put over. And as for Ric Flair, well, he will have his babyface turn as the days goes by, as the next Raw and pay-per-views happens. And as for Randy Orton and Triple H, they will be continuing their heel ways and they will go to their separate ways after this defeat. And Triple H will feud with Batista and Randy Orton will feud with Ric Flair because Ric Flair has this face turn and he will continue his legend versus legend killer gimmick. And as for The Undertaker, he just dominated a person in WrestleMania, thus continuing his streak. And as for Kane, he will lose the title, his Intercontinental title, before WrestleMania. That means Kane will also be involved in the Money in the Bank ladder match, which Edge will win that said match. And then Kane will kind of lose his momentum, just like in real life, where he will put over talents over him. And then Randy Orton, Batista, and The Undertaker will be drafted to SmackDown. And as for Raw, they will get John Cena and two more bigger stars for their draft. Why did I move The Undertaker on SmackDown? Well, they kind of need the star power of The Undertaker. And as for Raw, well, they have Triple H, HBK, and a lot of superstars in their roster. And that means also they will have John Cena on their side. And then Raw will have another two high caliber superstars as their pick. So The Undertaker will be moved to SmackDown in this time, and then he will feud with Randy Orton, because after his draft, after his said match in the draft, Randy Orton will kind of attack The Undertaker by RKOing him in this timeline, and they will have their feud until Armageddon 2005, just like in real life. And then everything goes smooth, just like in real life. What happened there happens here, except for The Undertaker SmackDown run in 2004 to 2005. And then as for Batista, well, he will be injured, and then in late 2005, and then Eddie, just like in real life, actually died, unfortunately. And then that is the start of Rey Mysterio's push to the main event scene, in which Kurt Angle will put Mysterio eventually at WrestleMania, and Randy Orton will be involved in that match too. And as for The Undertaker, he will go to a similar way, similar storylines. And then yeah, the only difference between here and in real life is he got a World Heavyweight Championship run earlier than expected, and he didn't feud with JBL. So who feuded with JBL, if you're asking me? Well, there's Eddie Guerrero, there's Booker T, and The Undertaker will not be involved. So they will build also John Cena during 2004 to 2005 and making him the huge babyface in SmackDown. And then yes, yeah, so unfortunately SmackDown has this huge gap because The Undertaker is not there in 2004 and 2005 when the creative team actually moved him to SmackDown. Because of this gap, well, they have this huge thing where they have this draft, and then The Undertaker actually moved to SmackDown in 2005. Just like in real life, The Undertaker's on SmackDown, and then he will have his run from here up to 2010, where he will actually be dedicated to SmackDown. And then as for the others, they will have their own similar run also, which they will actually try to challenge The Undertaker for a streak. Well, they weren't successful, just like in real life. And then Brock Lesnar unfortunately breaks the streak. So that's this short what if on The Undertaker actually moved to Raw in 2004. So what is the changes? As I told you, he will get a World Heavyweight Championship run. There will be no Randy Orton's early world title run, which actually lacks a lot of things, which people felt that he isn't ready. That's why he just got re-elected and
he actually returned to the mid-card scene, which he will build himself and he will find himself in the main event scene in 2006 and 2007, going forward up to the present. So yeah, thank you for watching, and I sincerely hope you enjoyed this episode. And if you enjoyed this, subscribe for more videos and like my content. Also, click on the bell to stay notified at every videos that I make. Thank you for watching, and I hope you had a good day. This is Mike Rato. Peace.